Hey, Pop.
Boy, you just not getting in from leaving this morning.
Yeah, I had to go to football practice.
Yeah, what?
Yes, sir.
I ain't been 2 seconds off, you know what? You got the garbage sitting up overflowing. You ain't done none of your chores. And you come in here telling me, yeah.
I was getting ready to do my chores now, Pop.
I know y'all. And your first chore after having me with that fence over there on the side. Everything else gonna come after that. Now you get that saw and you cut them boards.
I'm Troy, a 53-year-old man who has struggled hard in the late 1950s to take care of his family, but mainly to teach his son, Corey, here the true aspects in life.
And I'm Corey, his 16-year-old son who likes to play sports, but my father here believes in hard work and responsibility. And this results in your usual father and son confrontation. And that's where we're getting our play called Fences
by August Wilson.
Hey, Pop, the neighbors
then
went out and bought a TV. Now I want to know what you think about buying one.
Buying a TV? Now what I need with a TV, huh?
Because everybody got one.
But I ain't asking it. I said what I need with one.
What you think so we can watch it? There's lots of things on TV. Baseball games and everything. We could even watch the World Series for one.
All right, but tell me this. How much did TV cost, huh? Tell me that.
They got them on sale for around $200.
$200? Huh? What, please?
Oh, that ain't that much, Pop.
Son, it's just $200. You must have paid attention to that roof over your head that night, huh? Let me tell you something about that roof. It's been over 10 years since I last had that roof tore. Now, how much you think it's going to come to get that roof fixed?
I don't know.
$264 cash money. See, why you thinking about buying that TV? I got to be thinking about getting that roof fixed. Hell, what else been wrong around here? Now, if you had $200, what would you do? Buy a TV or get that roof in your house fixed?
I buy a TV, and then if the roof starts to leak, I get it fixed.
See, that's what I'm talking about. You're ignorant. Where you gonna get the money from? You spent it all on your brand new TV, son.
Oh, Pop, you got money? I know you do.
I got money? Where I got it? Tell me where I got it at.
Well, everybody got it at the bank.
The bank? Well, you wanna see my bank account? You wanna see the $72.60 I got up in there? I ain't got no money.
Pop, don't you understand? You'll have to pay for it all at one time. You can do like the neighbors, put a down payment on it, take it home with you today.
Boy, I ain't doing like nobody. You know, you miss one payment, they come snatch that TV right out of here. Then what you got? Now I didn't told. As soon as I get my money clear, I'm gonna just buy a TV. But as soon as I get $264, I'm gonna get that before my house.
Oh, Pop.
Well, you go on, you buy your TV. What else you want? For $200? I got better things to do with that type of money.
$200?
$200.
I can't get no $200. I ain't never seen $200.
Well, I'll tell you what. You get $100. I'll put the other bill on that for you.
All right, then I'm gonna show you.
How you gonna show me a cut them boards right now?
Hey, Pop, the Pirates won again today. That makes five in a row.
Boy, I ain't think about no Pirates. And besides, the Pirates got an all-white team. Got that little Puerto Rican boy. What's that boy's name?
Clemente.
Clemente, yeah. You know they don't play that boy half the game. You know that boy, he's seventh, they give him a chance.
He get a lot of chance to play.
Man, I'm talking about playing right. Playing every day. So you get your time. That's what I'm talking about.
They got some white guys on the team that don't play every day. It's not possible to play everybody at the same time.
Son, they got a white fella, and he's on the bench. That's because he can't play with the league. See, the color guy got to be twice as good to make that team. That's why I want you to get all tired of them sports. All them teams are the same.
Not the Braves. The Braves got Hank Aaron and Wade Thompson. Hank Aaron hit 2 home runs today. That makes 43.
No, Hank Aaron ain't nobody. That's what you're supposed to do. Hell, that's how you're supposed to play the game. I can hit 53 home runs right now, man.
Man, I'm no major league pitcher, you couldn't?
What you talking about? We had better pitchers in the Negro League. I remember the time your dad hit 7 home runs off Sasser Kane.
You sure it was 7?
7! You can't get no better than that.
Sandy Koufax, he's leading the league in strikeouts.
I ain't thinking about no Sandy Koufax.
You got Warren Spahn and Louis Verdant. I bet you couldn't hit no home run on Warren Spahn.
I'm doing that right now. You just get that jaw cut them more. Try to talk me out of some work. That's what you're doing. Oh, yeah. Your mama tell me you got recruited by some football team. Is that right?
Yeah, Coach Zimmer said the recruiter gonna come by and talk to you later. Get you to sign some permission papers.
I thought you were supposed to be working at that AMP office. You're supposed to be down there every day after school.
Yeah, Mr. Watkins ain't gonna hold my job for me until the football season. Say, starting next week, I'll be working weekends.
Son, I thought we had an understanding about this football stuff. You're supposed to keep up with your chores around the house. You hold that job at that AMP office. I've been around here all weekend. Now you come tell me you didn't quit your job.
I've been working weekends, Pop.
You damn right, Joe. And there ain't no need for nobody coming out here telling me to sign nothing.
Man, you can't do that. He come away from North Carolina.
Well, I don't care where I coming from. That white man ain't gonna let you get nowhere with that football no way. You learn how to fix cars, build houses or something. You get a trade, son. That way you have something, can't nobody take away from you.
I got good grades, Pop. That's why a recruiter wants to come by and talk to you. This way I'll be going to college. I have a chance.
First chance is gonna get your butt down into that NBL. See if you can get your job back.
I can't work out of school and practice too. The team needs me. I'm gonna coach them and say,
don't give me nobody say. I'm the boss around here. I do not understand what kind of. You understand that? I asked you a question. Did you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Then get the hell out of my face. Go down there to the NPL office and get your job back. Because you can't do both, son. You just gotta quit that football team. You gotta take the crickheads with the straight.
Can I ask you a question? How come you ain't never liked me?
Like you? Well, who in the hell said I gotta like you? Wanna stand up in my face and ask me a food club like that? Tell me I'm liking somebody. What else this ain't a guy like you?
Huh?
Yeah. Who like you? Don't you every day?
Yeah.
Boy, as long as you in my house, you gonna put the sound in there when you speak to me. Now don't you every day?
Yes, sir.
You got a roof on your head?
Yes, sir.
You got clothes on your back?
Yes, sir.
And Ted, why you think that is,
huh? It's because of you.
Oh, hell, I'm not because of me. I said, why do you think it is, son?
Because you like it. Because
I like you. Sit down, son. Listen, let me get something straight. I bust my butt every morning putting up with them crackers at work. Because I like you, you about the biggest fool I ever saw. It's my job, my responsibility. Now let me get something straight. I bust my butt every morning putting up with them crackers at work. Because I like you, you about the biggest fool I ever saw. It's my job, my responsibility. And besides, a man gotta take care of himself. If you're your belly room of food, see if you live behind him with bedclothes. Not because I like you. It's because I owe you. Hell, Mr. Randall can hand him my check every Friday because he liked me. He give it to me because he owed me, son. You understand that? And let me get another thing straight. I ain't got to like you. Because besides, me and your mama worked it out between us. And boy, believe me, my yellow black bird wasn't part of the bar. Oh, so free. Where's your mama? Listen here, son. Don't you go through life worried about who like you or not. You just make sure they do it right by you. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Good. Then get the hell out of my face. Go down to the NPL and see if you get your job back. Damn, I don't want that boy to be like me. I decided 17 years ago I wasn't gonna let that boy get hurt over playing no sports. Not after what they did to me. Hell no. That boy young, healthy. That wife of mine come tell me I was too old to play sports. I tell that wife of mine, uncle tell me I was too old. I just wasn't the right color hair. I'm 53 years old right now and I can do better than Sarah Curry, 269 batting average. And she tell me I got good sense. I tell her I'm gonna tell me I got some good sense. I know I got good sense. I got sense enough not to let my boy get hurt over playing those sports. I know that. That boy young, he gonna have to get out there on his own. Like his daddy. I made my way, he gonna have to make his. Ain't nobody gonna hold his hand out there in this world. But me, I do the best I can. I come in Friday morning, carrying a sack of potatoes and a bucket of lard. They all line up at the door with their hands out. I can mow the lint from my pocket. Give my sweat and blood. But I ain't got no tears. I ain't spent them all. I get up Monday morning, same routine. I find my lunch on the table, and then I go out. I make my living. Find my strength to carry me the next Friday. That's all I got. All I got to give. I can't get nothing else.